goods and services tax over imposed in the airports, because these are in the transit area, so it's a tax-free zone.
And do you know how the prices compare to, say, Europe or right, America?
I think it all depends on your exchange rate, but so far I think Singapore is pretty competitive, so we do get a lot of passengers purchasing products here. I, and I understand from the Louis Vuitton that they actually have special product just for Singapore.
Just for Singapore, right. Yeah. And I imagine you get the latest in the line as well.
I would think so, yes. Yeah. That's right.
Okay. Yeah.
So these are the services that we have, or the shopping that we have. Of course, we have a lot of F&B outlets, and we try to cater to different needs. So we have Chinese restaurants, we have Malay halal restaurants, and we do have Indian vegetarian restaurants as well. Different tiers so that we can cater to different needs of our passengers. So we do have a food court style where the prices are more affordable, and of course then we move on to actually a more mid-higher tier of restaurants in the airport.
Mm-hmm. Do you have an estimate of how many restaurants there are? It seems so countless, and there's so many choices.
I think there's easily over 100 food outlets in the airport. That's
right. And even the lounges here are some of the best I've been to. For example, the SQ Lounge, they serve a lot of local variety
that's
really special.
That's right.
Yeah. Which is your favorite restaurant here? I guess you're not allowed to say that.
It's hard because I think the variety is, it depends on really the mood that I like, but I think it really caters to, because I work here, so sometimes I need a sandwich, I actually have easy go to a sandwich bar. If I need a Chinese noodle, there's something available. So I think it's just a great variety that I think even I personally been working here for the last 4 years, I will never get sick of the food here.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think Changi's glory goes beyond the local airport. You guys are also helping to help to set up and manage some of the airport in the Krasnodar region in Russia. Could you tell us more about that?
Yes, we do have a subsidiary. It's called Changi Airport International. So what they do is they actually manage airports outside Changi. Outside Singapore, so Russia is, I think they have 4 airports that they're managing. So of course we also do management contract, and then Jeddah was the other airport that was recently signed and do management. So that was, these are some of the projects that they have abroad.
So Sochi Airport was actually
it was actually one of the airport that part of the CAI investments.
So CAI was very involved in helping it to get ready for the Olympics.
That was about 6 years ago, if I can remember correctly. Yeah.
Wow, wonderful. What about, you mentioned massage, is there any other extras? I mean, most airports have the basic essentials. What are some of the other extras that you can tell us that kind of put Singapore Airport at the forefront? I saw some the special decorations, is that the kinetic ring?
Right, okay, yeah. When it comes to art installations, I think that's something that we are getting a bit more involved. So I think we have the kinetic ring. That was in Terminal 1, and it's actually a moving raindrop that synchronizes with a certain technology that we work with a German supplier. So I think it kind of like moves and it creates a very therapeutic scene.
It does.
Of course, with that, I think in Terminal 4, we have this moving cloud patterns. So these cloud patterns will move in a certain pattern, and it's actually quite therapeutic as well. And in Terminal 2, recently, we have put up a million time clock. So it's actually a very big installations where you see different lines moving together and can tell time in every 2 minutes.
Oh.
And then otherwise they'll just move in a sequential patterns, which again it provide a bit of wow factor for our passengers.
Mm. And one of the things I cannot help but notice is how well the sound is contained here. This is a huge airport with huge traffic, but you know, I see some really large carpet, not in all areas, but what do you do as far as sound barriers and sound minimization is concerned?
I guess the carpet helps with minimizing some of the noise, but of course I think what we do in the airport is we actually remove some of the non-essential announcements. Say for example, the flight last call, for example. So recently we removed that. So it makes the airport a lot quieter and actually allows a lot more stress-free travel for our passengers. Of course, if there is some exigencies, for example, the flight gate change, which just now you heard in the earlier sections, we will make the announcement for that. But otherwise, for like say your flight don't depart as according to schedule, we will avoid making the kind of announcements.
Mm-hmm.
So that really reduces the noise level.
Right. And I'm looking at this, I'm sure it's more than just aesthetic.
Yeah.
Does this actually control the amount of natural lighting coming through?
Yes, in Terminal 3, I think we are trying to do to be a bit more green in terms of energy conservation. So we actually have a roof that allows natural light to come in. So that will reduce the reliance on the electricity. Of course, unless it's a day where it's overcast or it gets dark because of rain, then the electricity will kick in. the lights are kicked in. Otherwise, we use natural light.
Does every terminal has a particular theme?
So far, I think the newer ones, because Terminal 1 and 2, they are pretty old. Mm-hmm. So Terminal 3, I think we try to use this natural light. And of course, we have this huge green wall that settles between level the departure and arrival level. So anyone in both levels can actually see this huge green wall, which is right above the carousel.
You mentioned, but it actually looks very new. Have you guys gone in and done renovations from time to time?
Yes, we do. We do refresh our terminal quite regularly. So for Terminal 1, I think we are currently going in an expansion program to fit in this new upcoming project called Jewel, which I'll share a little bit more later. So Terminal 1 is currently going through what we call the Terminal 1 expansion. And we are looking into Terminal 2 revamp in the next couple of years. Of course, Terminal 4 is the latest addition to the whole airport, and it was opened October last year.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and how long has Changi Airport been in operations?
Since 1981. So
is that the same time as Singapore Airlines? Or?
No, they are way longer, because we moved from previously from Paya Lebar, there's this Kallang, and then we moved mm-hmm. to Changi, which is on the east coast of the Singapore. Mm-hmm.
And over the years, can you share some of the growing pains, some of the things that you decided to do away with, some of the things that you changed to keep up with modern day needs?
Right. Okay. I guess the most common one that's the internet. I guess we offer free Wi-Fi in the airport. I think as with most airport, I think these are the growing needs, and we do actually put in a lot of facilities to help with our passengers in terms of wayfinding. We have kiosks that, by just scanning your boarding passes, can tell you exactly where you are and where you're supposed to go. So in a directional map form, so a digital directional map form. So I thought that will help with the wayfinding. And of course, it's easy for them to search certain things, whether shops online, or even we have an iChangi app that allows you to even do wayfinding using the app.
With the Wi-Fi, I noticed there are kiosks that you have to scan your passport for a code to get on the Wi-Fi. Is there a reason to do this extra step? Why not just let them log on?
This is actually a requirement with our Ministry of Home Affairs. So I guess it's a bit of a security, especially after 911. So I think we have put in this additional proportion. But even though, yes, it's an additional step, but it's a very straightforward and easy step for our passengers.
And there's so many kiosks. So that's just one example. I've also seen kiosks for photo taking,
yes,
and kiosks for customer service feedback in the bathroom and just about everywhere. How many clicks do you get from this customer service kiosk that we see everywhere, and how often do you look at the data and what do you do about it?
Right, we get lots of clicks. I think if you put them all together, it really goes in tens of thousands per month. We do review our feedbacks that we get. Say for example, we have this instant feedback systems that we put in almost all the passengers' toilets. So by rating whether you're happy or unhappy with the toilets, it gives us a bit of feedbacks. And there are two ways to look at it. One is actually to allow instant feedback that we can address certain issues that passengers give to us instantly. So say for example, if let's say they point that they are unhappy with the toilet because there's not enough toilet paper. So by putting that in.
Oh, so there's an option for them to detail.
And then we can tell, and then we will send passengers into the toilet, cleaners into the toilet to address that. And of course, over time, we collect this data so that we can actually understand which are the toilets that are highly frequent and which one tends to have a bit more issue.
Mm-hmm. And toilets aside, where else can we find this customer service kiosk?
In all the information counters as well. So it's to rate our service agent to make sure that they provide a good customer service. So you can actually rate them. If let's say you're unhappy, of course, we will ask you why. And then, just that give a feedback, allow us to do trending. And also try to understand, maybe not all of the staff are good for customer service. And then for staff with the account issues, we actually do trainings and retraining using the data that we collect.
Mm. Well, Singapore has an advantage in that the country itself is very multilingual. Mm. What about your customer service staff? Do you provide?
Yes, we do have a certain set of requirements in terms of languages. So we do, of course, based on our top 10 destinations of travelers coming into Singapore, so we try to make sure we have enough language speaking ability. Say for example, we do get a lot of Chinese passengers, so we must make sure that in every terminal there will be at least one Chinese speaking agent so that they can help to do the translation if need to.
And the signs, as I can find in the whole of Singapore, there are signs in different languages.
Yes,
and those were the four languges
that we have. Yeah. Yes,
they
right.
have it in English, Malay, Tamil
and Chinese.
And Chinese,
yeah.
Right. I see. Yeah. Well, from the time that my plane lands, how soon can I expect to pick up my luggage?
Wow, that's we will try to be as efficient as we can. So so a general rule of thumb, it's the moment that you do arrive and to the time you bought your taxis or your tour coach, we hope to achieve in less than half an hour.
Wow. That's so right. Not even pick up luggage from the time
to pick up your transport, your ground transport to leave the airport. So we hope to achieve that, everything within half an hour.
That's fabulous. Now I know airlines sometimes have a penchant for sending our baggages to where we are not going. What does the Changi do in terms of helping passengers with retrieving lost baggages? Do you collaborate with the airlines?
Yes, we work very closely with the airlines. So of course such services is provided by the airlines, and we work with them to make sure that they actually are passengers in distress, especially when you arrive and you find that your bag is missing. So we work with the ground handling agents to make sure that the experience will be minimized, at least to help them with the distress.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And as far as heightened security, do you have your own security staff or do you work closely with the Singapore Police Force?
We do have the Airport Police Division that's working here, and in addition, of course, they do the law and order maintenance of the airport. Of course, when it comes to pre-board screening, we actually have an auxiliary police team. It's at Certis Cisco, so they look after the pre-board security. So yes, we do make sure that the airport is safe. Of course, we have certain features that we put in to ensure that the Changi Airport is safe.
Well, thank you so much, Mr. Teo. Thanks for being with us today.
No problem. Yeah, thank you so much.
And congratulations, and we look forward to Terminal 5.
Thank you.